we are indeed discussing resilience today, basically looking at the global trends in terms of acute food insecurity. That means the type of food insecurity that may lead to famine type of situation if not being addressed. And we saw that unfortunately, globally, for the last 3 years, the number of people in acute food insecurity remains well over 100 million. There is no way we are going to reach the SDG 2 on eradicating hunger if we are not able to address acute food insecurity, to address chronic food insecurity, and therefore build the resilience of especially those vulnerable farmers that are regularly hit by a variety of shocks, mainly conflict, unfortunately, in the world today, but also the increasing impact of extreme weather events, as well as the impact of economic shocks.
The process of this workshop can be summarized in three main points. The first is to try to identify, to understand the issue. And this is about taking stock of our work, our collaboration with our partners. So the second point is to agree on the priority. What are the priority area of focus for joint programming? And then the next point is to agree with our partners, including the African Union Commission, SILS, IGAD, but also our UN colleague, WAFO program, the World Bank, UNICEF, on the next step for concrete action for a joint program.
Well, first of all, we have to stress that Africa is the one which is most affected by the impact of climate change, and particularly smallholder farmers, the pastoralist communities, which are actually residing in dryland areas, are the most affected. For this, we have to intervene in building the capacity of these communities towards their adaptive capacity. And in this instance, actually, FAO and other development partners have supported communities so that they can actually recover from impacts of climate change.
I think the most important thing here is that we don't have to reinvent the wheel, but simply build on what already exists in terms of coordination mechanism in Africa. And FAO, as an international organization, through its knowledge and its network, particularly through the Global Network Against Food Crisis, that is this new initiative, can bring some substantial added value.
I really hope that after this 2 days, my colleagues are able to really understand and integrate social protection as one key strategy around resilience, but most importantly, that we can enhance our efforts with partners such as the African Union, SEAL, SADC, and others to really have a comprehensive strategy to really accelerate progress around Malabo and around SDG 1 and 2.
So this is a chance to collaborate, to listen to the best practices, to share what we're all doing, and seeing how we can really crystallize that and identify what we want to take and move forward. So we've worked around the different themes. We've had different presentations. We've asked questions to clarify what we're meaning and really where the gaps are.